Here we are in our third video about React Native Skeleton. So in this video, we will look into more deeper into our React Native Skeleton, and we will learn how we can modify our splash screen, how the no internet functionality works. So this is my environment over here, as you can see. Here I have modified this package.json. And here I have added two packages over here. One is React Native Linear Gradient, and another one is React Native Loading Dots. So we will need these two packages for our splash screen. So the existing splash screen that we are having, which is the one, the splash.js, it don't have that dependency. We don't have the dependency which we have mentioned in this package.json. So, but the splash screen that I'm going to create right now, it will need these two packages. So what I will gonna do is that I will gonna simply run yarn install. So it will install all those node modules. I have changed the environment from my previous video. So this is the new environment, that's why I'm doing this again. We have successfully installed all those node modules. Now we will run yarn android. Build was successful. It's about to launch in our emulator right now. So as you can see, our view has been loaded. So let me reload this application again, so you can see the splash screen, how's the actual the splash screen works. So this is the splash screen that we are having right now, and we are going to modify it to a different look. So what we are going to do is that I have the source code with me already, so I'm copying this code and I'm going to paste it over here. So before pasting it, you can see what are the actual code. So here we have a simple splash screen with an image background and a fade in view implemented over here. So we are going to change this behavior, and we are going to create a new splash screen. So let me paste it over here. Now let me save this. So as you can see that we are using these two packages, React Native Linear Gradient and React Native Loading Dot. So these are the two packages that we have added into our package.json, and I ran the yarn install over here. Now if I'm going to refresh this, you can see that the splash screen has been modified. So here we have a gradient color as a background. Oops, let me refresh it again. Yeah, we have a gradient background, and we have a logo over here, and we have the loading dots over here. So once the web view has been loaded, the splash screen will hide by itself, and the web view will get loaded. So this is in this way you can customize your splash screen. So for an example, I can change this color into some other color, like some gray color I'm going to use here. So you can see that it will change. As you can see, yes, it's updated with the color that I gave over here. And as you can see, we can also change the logo. So you can see in this image component, we are using the URI logo. So from where this logo is coming, right? So for that, you have to go to this Android app, src main resources drawable logo. So here you can see the logo, right? So you can simply update this logo.jpg file and it will reflect over here. And you can also use PNG file if you need, you can use it as well. And we are using this package called loading dot. So this is the component of it, loading dots. Here you can mention how many dots you need, what should be the size of it, what should be the color of those dots. The dots, this is the dots that I'm talking about. I'm talking about this loading dot. So you can change the behavior of these loading dots. For that, we can simply do one thing, just go into the package.json and just copy this package name React Native loading dots and just give a search Google, and you can see React Native loading dots npm. So if you go inside into the npm, can see different configurations that you can use, like dots, colors, size, border radius. So you can refer to this npm.js website and you can modify it.